So, for the second time, the streets of downtown were once again filled with the Indy cars on the 1.7 mile 9 turn course. And long story short, the overall base of this race was an embarrassment and crash fest. In total, there were 8 cautions, with most of them taking place at turn 3. Several incidents happened involving drivers like Christian Lundgaard, Roman Grosjean, Marcus Armstrong, Will Power, Linus Lundqvist, Jack Harvey, Santino Ferrucci, Alexander Rossi, Pato Award, and other drivers. With some rain coming into the race, around lap 33 or 34, it mixed things up a bit on strategy, and it looked like it was going to make the race be a little bit more entertaining. The highlight of the race was with 2 laps to go when Marcus Ericsson passed Marcus Armstrong in turn 3, allowing for him to finish 2nd in the race, with Armstrong trailing behind him finishing 3rd. Now, there are some drivers that I do want to mention after this race, and those drivers are Felix and Will. Felix definitely deserves a mention after charging from 22nd to 8th. And Will Power, after facing 4 penalties, somehow manages to finish 6th. As for the venue, it was a huge success for Penske, with sold out grandstands and hospitalities. Penske Corporation definitely had a very positive outlook after what happened in the race. But not everybody loved this race, especially the drivers. The Potable Ward making a tweet saying, "I miss Belle Isle," with Graham Rahal replying, "Me too." And Ryan Hunter-Reay posting a tweet, "Detroit Grand Prix appreciation post," showing the image of the 2014 Grand Prix back in Belle Isle. And my final thoughts, I honestly think IndyCar should return back to Belle Isle. I think it would do a better job over there, especially having less cautions and have a series not look like an amateur go-kart race. Anyways, guys, this was Indy Talk. I'll catch you guys in the next video.